So the characteristic of ensemble learning is first this, that you take a bunch of simple rules, all of which kind of make sense and you can see as sort of helping, but on their own individually do not give you a good answer. And then you magically combine them in some way to create a more complex rule that in fact works really well. And ensemble learning algorithms have a sort of basic form to them that can be described in just one or two lines. So let me do that, and then we can start wondering a little bit how we're going to make that real. So here's the basic form of an ensemble learning algorithm. Basically, you learn over a subset of the data, and that generates some kind of a rule. And then you learn over another subset of the data, and that generates a different rule. And then you learn over another subset of the data, and that generates yet a third rule, and yet a fourth rule, and yet a fifth rule, and so on and so forth. And then eventually you take all of those rules, and you combine them into one of these complex rules. So we might imagine in the email case that I might look at a small subset of email that I know is already spam and discover that the word manly shows up in all of them and therefore pick that up as a rule that's going to be good at that subset of mail but not necessarily be good at the other subset of mail. And do the same thing and discover that a lot of the spam mails are in fact short, or a lot of them are just images or just URLs and so on and so forth. And that's how I learn these rules, by looking at different subsets. Which is why you end up with rules that are very good at a small set of the data but aren't necessarily good at a large set of the data. And then after you've collected these rules, you combine them in some way, and there you go. And that's really the beginning and the end of ensemble learning.
So when you say manly was in a lot of the positive examples, do you mean like it distinguishes the positive and the negative example? So it should also not be in the negative examples.
That's right. That's exactly right. So think of this as any other classification learning problem that you would have, where you're trying to come up with some way to distinguish between the positives and the negatives.
And now why are we looking at subsets of the data? I don't understand why we can't just look at the whole data.
Well, if we look at all of the data, then it's going to be hard to come up with these simple rules. That's the basic answer. Actually, ask me that question a little bit later when we talk about overfitting, and I think I'll have a good answer for you. Okay, so here we go, Michael. This is ensemble learning. You learn over a subset of the data over and over again, picking up new rules, and then you combine them, and you're done.